Oh girl, I think I want you now. I wanna see what you about. Bomb chicka, womp, womp. If I get you, girl, I'd be proud.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is sponsored by Nana Hair, Nene Hair, one of those. But I got a frontal in three bundles. So I'm going to take the frontal out first. I got a nice size frontal, lots of parting space. I'm going to enjoy working with this. And then the bundles, I got two 26 inch and one 24 inch. And just taking one out the pack so you can see. And then what I did was I made it into a wig, and I used all three bundles, and this hair is super full, very, very full, and the bundles are nice and long, and I'm going to get more wears out of it in a wig than I would with a sew-in. So that's why I did that, and I'm just showing you the construction of it. And I used a extra large dome cap to make it. I have a small head, but I like to use the larger ones because when I sew the tracks on, it makes the cap tighter, so I have lots of breathing space. So what I'm doing here is parting off a section of the hair because I want to do a patch of color. So I'm just going to clip out the hair that I'm not using out of the way so that I can get my section. I don't want that much hair, just enough where the color can be visible, and I'm doing it on the side and not in the middle. So I have my aluminum foil so that it doesn't get on the rest of the hair, and I just start applying it right onto the hair. I already have my mix. I do a pretty loose bleach mix. I don't want it to be thick because I want it to easily go through the hair. It'll be easier to apply, but because this is a small section, it will not be hard to bleach at all. And also the aluminum foil will help heat up the product. When it heats up, it processes a lot better and a lot quicker. So if you're just applying the bleach and you're not placing anything over it to keep the heat in, you'll notice it doesn't get as blonde. So doing this, it will help the hair get as blonde as possible because I am doing a very light color. And I did have to do a second layer just because the roots did not get as blonde, and also the hair underneath did not get bleached. So I did two layers and I got it to a pretty light colored blonde. So I was very happy about that, and I let it sit for about 20 to 30 minutes. So I'm doing the watercolor method because that's the easiest way, and I'm using the Adore Green Apple, and I absolutely love this color. Very pretty, very vibrant. So I'm just dipping it in there, and it took to the color really quick, and I didn't stain my hands, but it definitely stained my nails. And here I was just adding more water in the bowl. I didn't want to use that much water because I didn't want to waste product, but just to make sure that the bleach or that the hair color gets onto the hair all the way to the root, I just filled it up so I didn't have to dip the whole wig. And this is after I rinsed the color out, I let it air dry, and I'm just placing on my head, just seeing how it fits and how it looks. I did bleach the knots and I tinted the lace, as you can see, a nice brown. And here I'm just going over the hairline with a wax stick so that I can hot comb it. And I did not pluck this hairline. You'll see when I start hot combing it, you can see it a little bit better, but this hairline was really nice. It wasn't super dense or super thick where I had to do a lot of plucking. I literally just left it as it was. This down, I'm very excited. So I'm only applying one layer of the bold hold lace glue, and this one layer is really like two layers because I do squeeze out a lot, but I only do this one layer, and then I just blend it out with the comb, just making sure I blend it out evenly so that it dries down nice and quick and that there's no lumps of glue. And then once it has dried down clear, I just go ahead and I lay that lace right on top. I stick the middle down first, and then I do the sides one at a time. And I'm just going over that lace again while I have it tied down with an elastic band. And you guys can see it's looking like skin melt already. It looks so good just with the elastic band on. And I'm also running the hot comb through the hair, which I normally never do, but I was just curious. I wanted to see what it would do for the hair. So at this point, it's been a good 10 minutes. The glue should definitely be all the way completely dried down. So I just start cutting off the lace. I cut in the middle and then I just cut one side at a time. Because I'm left-handed, I can only hold the scissors a certain way. So I like to cut this way. And if you see some steam, it's just coming off of the hot comb because it's still on. So I actually wore this look for like a day. These are like different days that I've been working on this wig. But I wore it for a day without baby hairs and I really liked it. But I decided to add baby hair, so that's what I'm doing. I'm only doing these two on the side. I didn't even do sideburns, which is not like me. But yeah, I just cut out, I pulled out some hair and then I cut it and I laid it with Eco Styling Gel. And I did it to both sides. On this side, it did have some of the green in it, which I was expecting. I kind of wanted that look. And that's all that I'm doing. So I decided to do some curls. I'm doing, I would say wand curls, even though I'm not using a wand curler, but the way that I'm wrapping it around the barrel is how I would do a wand curl. And then I'm also pinning it up because this hair is like a straight texture. So just to make sure that the curls hold and that they last, I'm just putting pins in them so that they can sit into place. And then once you're done, you definitely want to go over that with a good hairspray or holding spray just to make sure that they last for a good amount of time. You don't want to waste your time doing these curls and then they fall. So that's also really important when you're doing pin curls. Some of them failed because I was changing my clothes and I was pulling stuff over my head, but it's cool. So at this point, I'm taking the pins out, and as you can see, they are falling beautifully. Like, this looks so good. They came out better than I had thought they would because I've only done this maybe, I don't even know, a couple of times. Normally, I would just pin the bangs and that's it. But like I said, I really just wanted this to come out really bomb. So I'm glad that I did that because, like I said, you guys can see for yourself just how good like this came out. I need to do this every time I curl hair, literally. It honestly did not take that long to do. That extra step of adding the pins, it did not add on time of curling, not to me. I feel like I went through this pretty fast. I sped through the hair really quickly. And someone commented on Instagram that it's giving Shego, and I didn't even think of that. That's literally perfect for Halloween, but I love the pop of color. I love the hair, super full. Like I said, three bundles, 226, 124, and then the frontal was also full as well. So it's a lot of hair on my head, but I love it. It was easy to work with. The frontal is amazing, blended well, was not hard to do anything to, like the hair, everything. It just, everything came out perfect. So I will have all the details.